Continuing our team coverage, there is now a bacteria warning on one Collier County beach. NBC2's Alexa Santos is live at the Naples Pier, where a warning sign was just posted this afternoon.
Yeah, well, the Collier County Department of Health isn't exactly sure what's causing these high bacteria levels. They say it could be a combination of recreation use, the high winds and high tides, or runoff from rain. But as you can see, the conditions haven't kept people from enjoying the surf today. These intense waves are nowhere near typical for Naples. Surfers and bodyboarders like Adam Marshall came to the beach prepared to take advantage.
I'm glad to get out and be on the water again. It's been 2 years, so it's been good.
Since Hurricane Michael has been churning up the waters in the Gulf the last couple of days, the tides have become much higher in our area.
So just under regular conditions, it was a very high tide. Now you take the pressure of the hurricane pushing down on the Gulf of Mexico, that water all got displaced, so we literally had no sand left on Naples Beach.
Even hardcore swimmers hit the water Wednesday.
It's tiring. It taxes you, you know. You don't have a board, you can't skim across the top.
Despite the danger the storm is causing up north, it's creating a rare yet exciting occurrence for some on the beaches of Naples.
When you have them out in the Gulf like that, we get them nice for like 2 days of waves.
And your body's all warm and crisp from the sea salt. And it's so good doing it here in Naples, you know?
It's actually not just the pier that's experiencing these higher levels of bacteria. It's also Wiggins Pass, Residence Beach, South Marco Beach, Park Shore, Barefoot Beach, Vanderbilt Beach, and Seagate Beach. The Department of Health is recommending that if you do go in the water, make sure you shower off afterwards and be very careful not to swallow any water. Reporting live in Naples, Alexa Santos, NBC2.